Yeah, today's a reset day. A reset day. But sometimes you need like a reset day where you just kind of like get your shit together. They're posting basically in real time while they're there. So there's a lot of criminal organizations down here, and I know this because of when I used to be an EMT and stuff, and they like to go into places like Coachella, and because, you know, people, these criminal organizations, like the one, like the guy I breathed for who had the tat, yeah, they'll go into these places and target people to like steal, mug. They don't care. I mean, these are people who are running, like, drugs from Mexico. They don't care, okay? And so they will, to pick up extra money, you know, go into, like, the festivals and stuff and mug and chisel people.
Bitches!
Well, who lost her vlog camera because her friends weren't paying attention to her while she was drinking? Alicia, like I said, watch your drunk friends. She's lucky that's all that's happened so far. I saw that and I'm like, yeah, your friends don't watch you while you drink. They don't care. You lost your vlog camera. How much was that? Gonna get Canon to send you another one, Alicia? Like, that is... Your friends were not paying attention to you. This is proof. This is proof. I told you, like, be careful. Watch your drunk friends. And that includes things being stolen from them, not just them getting raped in the parking lot. This proves to me that her friends are shitty. Like, shit like that happens, but a couple years ago when she was there with Remy, she had her phone stolen. She's had her phone stolen. She's had her vlog camera stolen. You didn't lose it. It was stolen. Because your friends weren't paying attention and someone was watching you and watching you to make, you know, until you weren't paying attention completely so they can snatch your shit and take it. That's what happened with this. They were watching them. They knew they were inebriated and drunk. And they targeted Alicia. You were targeted. This isn't just I lost it. This wasn't just it was stolen. There are people who go to Coachella to purposely target dumb influencers and steal their shit. And then they all pawn it and split the money at the end of the thing. I'm not kidding. Yeah, so I'm working on yesterday's vlog. I was about to do my thumbnail and then I saw that. I got like a notification and I was like, oh, you know, like my favorite nephew liked my picture. I love him so much. His name's Cody Granger and he is on the Royal Jags cheerleading team. Like he's like an all-star cheerleader and stuff. So like he's my favorite nephew ever and he's just so talented and stuff. So like whenever I see that he likes one of my things or something, I immediately go over and check it out and stuff because he's my favorite nephew and I love him so much. So yeah, I saw that when I got on there. I was like, oh, and then like, oh, so yeah. Yeah, my nephew, he has a YouTube channel too where he shows like his cheerleading and stuff. So if I remember, I will link it below his channel. Like really, I think he's gonna blow up eventually on YouTube and social media if he keeps up with it, if he wants to, because he's just so freaking talented and stuff, and I'm just so proud of him. I'm a proud aunt, so yeah. But I saw that with Alicia and I'm like, girl. So yeah, so I'm watching Girl World. I'm like, I need this after having to deal with influencers and shit and Reddits and shit. The people on the Reddit think I'm delusional. They're like, well, your channel's just so small. Your biggest views are like 1,000. And I'm like, yeah, that's the point. When you're that small, you can go into your back analytics and you can refine for regions and cities. And I don't know anybody in LA who watches my shit. Like, you know, where you get like 3 views that are Comcasted or what is it, Chromecasted from the phone to the TV, because they show you what devices people will play. And so there's one real show where people like to cast, where when people, someone casts from YouTube to a big TV. We've seen them all do that. We've seen them all sit around and do that. So, I mean, and the algorithm too. If someone does a video about you, the algorithm and your name is in it, they're going to recommend it to you. I've added them. It'll notify you when someone adds you. Peter Mon has said this for years, and he's been around the block, that these YouTubers love to... YouTubers? Like, and I would too. If someone did a video about me, I'd want to go watch it. Like, YouTubers, they're kind of narcissistic, like, where they're like, I want to know what someone else is saying about me. Like, and they will go and look. Like, a lot of them will go and look because they want to know. And then they just call them a hater and stuff like that. And then that's when you start seeing, I have haters. Like, we've seen Remy address the snark. I mean, with the iPhone thing and the Samsung ads, and she just did it with, you know, the frozen dinner and telling Cal, look, I'm forcing Cal to be in my vlog. She's going over to the snark. Like, I'm pretty sure some of those people who are posting on the snark are, like, her friends and her. Like, back in the day, Remy used to post to her guru gossip. That was the rumor, at least, that she posted to her own guru gossip and got that starting. Because she thought it was going to make her big. You know what I mean? Yeah. I've heard of other people doing that. Like, Creepshow Art used to do that. Creepshow Art did that to get herself up there. She'd go on Lolcow and she would post shit about herself. She would talk shit about herself. It's crazy. It's crazy. And then people think, oh, because... who is this? What is this negative thing? And then they'll go watch them and it gets them views and shit. Like, one of the ways to blow up is drama. Yeah, drama. So I'm going to edit my thumbnail. My thumbnail, my video today. Listening, I can hear Coachella with my slider open. It's just so funny. I can hear the person, like, I could hear the wah, 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 wah. And I'm like, what the fuck? So, yeah. Get that done, and then I'm probably going to work on my picture because we're getting there. I wanted to get out of the house today, but I think it would be better to have a good reset day today. So today's going to be like a reset day where I kind of just get on top of my pain. I think I'm going to pick up some stuff in my bedroom, me and Patrick's bedroom. You know, get some organized for the week. Patrick's got work tomorrow, so... it's going to be a work week, so I want to get back on track with the treadmill, so I think that's what's going to happen. So, yeah, today's a reset day, but sometimes you need, like, a reset day where you just kind of, like, get your shit together and kind of, like, okay, I need to get it together, because in the last vlog I said, like, I feel like my depression could be coming on, and so I'm hoping that maybe just, like, having a reset day and, like, taking the day to get it together and then working on some art and just, like, being with myself and listening to some music will help with that. Like, that's one of those things that, like, it helps. So there's things you can do to help, you know, and like I said, my hormones are fucked up. My brain chemistry is fucked up. And I've been through a lot of things. So sometimes depression, I just get it just because. It's just the way my brain is. Sometimes that just happens. And there's no trigger in life. It's not because my life is bad or this and that happened to me or I wish I had more. It's just my brain chemistry is fucked. My body's fucked up. This is my brain, and I've been through a lot of trauma. My nerve system is fucked. So I have to be aware of these things, you know? They're like symptoms of, like, you know, like, if I had, like, let's say I had epilepsy. And some people can tell when they're going to have a seizure. They'll have little symptoms. And they know, like, okay, this is when I need to take the medication now for my epilepsy. Well, I feel like it's like that, where it's like, okay, I can feel this coming on. Now I need to do the work to help mitigate that. Do you see what I'm saying? And then, you know, I know if doing the work to mitigate that doesn't work, then I need to talk to my doctor about adjusting my meds. And I have a whole, like, it's helped me, but, like, thinking of, like, a system, I guess, for when I feel this way, I know that I need to do this in order to get better. And sometimes that can be hard. It's hard to recognize when you're in that fog or that depression fog. And that's when it helps to have other people around you to maybe point that out sometimes. But it just, it's, as you get older and as time goes on, you learn to be more self-aware of your mental health, your triggers, your illnesses, your symptoms of things, and know how to mitigate them. It just, sometimes it just takes time and experience and knowing yourself and listening to yourself. So yeah, I'm gonna get this thumbnail done. I gotta get this video uploaded. We're on our way though. Reset day. Hello. So the best thing happened. My favorite nephew uploaded. Not kidding. Like, it's like, I don't know. It just brightened my day to see. And so he did a week in a life vlog, and I'm gonna link that in my description box and probably in the comments as well. He is on the Royal Jags, and they are about to go to Worlds in Florida for cheer. So, yeah, him and his boyfriend, and they're so cute. I feel like his boyfriend's like my other nephew, too. So I just love them so much. They're so cute. So he does a week in a life vlog, and he shows him and his boyfriend and him at cheer and, you know, just his life. And I'm just so proud of him because he's really going places and he's overcome a lot. So I'm just so proud of him and Chris. And so it's Cody and Chris. And yeah, so Cody Granger is his YouTube channel, and I will link it. And yeah, he shares his life, you know, building his cheerleading career and stuff. And yeah, and sharing his life with his boyfriend and, you know, their trips and just everything he's doing with his life. So me and Patrick are just so freaking proud of them. So yeah, so we are cooking. We are meal prepping. So Patrick prepped, we call it protein oatmeal. So it's like oatmeal with egg white. So it's like we do a half a cup of oatmeal to a half a cup of, no, it's one serving of oatmeal. Yeah, which is like the half cup to a half cup of egg whites. And it kind of fluffs up and it makes a lot. So we're gonna be having that for breakfast. So we're meal prepping so we can get back on track. Like I said, this is a reset vlog, so this is part of the reset. So yeah, and then I have some like chicken breast that he had the butcher. You can always like have the butcher like cut the meat for you, you know, and slice it thinner or something. So I had him like, he had the butcher cut the chicken breast a lot thinner and then cut off the little extra fat that was still on there. And then so what we did was we got some Italian dressing and coated it, and then he got shredded Parmesan cheese, not grated Parmesan cheese like the recipe. And it's a recipe that my mom sent me on Instagram. I will try to find like if there's like a blog or something and link it, but it was like just like Italian dressing and grated Parmesan cheese, and then you bake it for like 420 degrees or something for like, I don't know. So yeah, I'm trying to remember the recipe, but yeah, is it 425? I don't know, for like, you know, until they're done or whatever. So yeah, I just, you know, chicken and stuff, because we cook it in the, we cook our stuff in this little toaster oven because it doesn't heat up the apartment. So, I mean, yeah, that helps. Oh, yeah. It's my vlog. Oh, it is ready. Yay. My vlog is ready. I can hear Coachella from my slider. Public. Done. Save. Boop, boop. That's fun. Yeah, so, found some clips on the internet about what I was talking about the woman who was assaulted at Coachella. It was like 10 years ago, but it was like a 17-year-old girl who was assaulted. It wasn't Coachella, it was Stagecoach. And she was pulled into a porta potty and assaulted by three men.
With all the excitement of Stagecoach, the Indio police made 57 arrests last night, mostly alcohol related. And tonight they have their hands full after an assault that sent one girl to the hospital. According to police, they're searching for three men with blonde hair who allegedly sexually assaulted a 17-year-old girl inside a portable bathroom. It happened around 8:30 last night, just near the entrance of the event off Avenue 51. The victim was taken to a local hospital for medical treatment.
Yeah. So that happens. And then I found a bunch of other videos. There was a woman who actually did an expose about how women are regularly assaulted at Coachella and other festivals.
More and more are coming forward to say they have been groped at Coachella. So we decided to investigate.
Then he put his hands like on my waist and kind of just started like feeling me basically.
In a Teen Vogue article, reporter Vera Papasova says she was repeatedly sexually assaulted at the concert.
I was groped 22 times.
And she said she interviewed 54 concert goers who told her they had similar experiences.
I was dancing at a set and some guy came up and grabbed my butt and was trying to touch me, and it made me feel uncomfortable.
I was standing there by myself trying to take a picture and this guy just comes up and tries to kiss me.
Have you guys seen anything here that's been disturbing in terms of men's behavior towards women?
Yeah, there was definitely a security guard who was staring at all of the women's behinds and breasts as they were walking by. That made us feel extremely uncomfortable.
A security guard.
According to TMZ, Justin Bieber saw a man assaulting a woman during a Coachella party on Saturday and immediately sprang into action.
Safety experts say women should always try to stay with friends and never take drinks from strangers.
And it's actually more prevalent than you think, to the point where Golden Voice allowed this like nonprofit a few years ago to have a tent with a counselor for women who get assaulted at Coachella. I bring this up because I was concerned that, you know, like, here's Alicia. She's had her phone stolen, which I'm going to look on the YouTubes here, but from what I remember, there was like a group that was targeting people with iPhones and then they were sending them back to like China.
But you also need to be aware that you may be the target of bad guys bent on stealing your phone. Every year, thousands of phones are pickpocketed by professional thieves, taking advantage of fans who are distracted by the music and excitement of a live concert event.
When these concert goers in Las Vegas found an abandoned bag, they discovered it was filled with stolen phones.
Keep all the stuff together.
Yeah. Each phone had been wrapped in tinfoil to prevent GPS tracking. Kyle Manning was with his girlfriend at Lollapalooza, the famed music festival held every summer in Chicago. He says a crook deliberately bumped into him and he was knocked into the arms of an accomplice who swiped his phone.
It felt like a scene out of like Ocean's 11.
But they would go to music festivals and they would target people. And here's the thing. I posted a picture on Instagram the other day and I was just being like, okay, like usually the Indio thing, I think my camera's gonna die soon, but so if it goes, like, I'll be right back. Oh, look, I still have the bunny. I'm gonna sit here in the wingback chair. Oh, yeah. So, where was I at? So, yeah, usually the Indio location tag, there's like nobody posting to it. It's usually like me and like a bunch of other people, like restaurants or, you know, normal people, right? There's usually no big Instagrammers, you know, big accounts posting to that location, right? Tagging that location. Well, I like to go over there because during Coachella, everybody's tagging Indio because they're down here for the festival. And so you see like these huge accounts, and it's really funny to see the Indio location switch from like it's like normal one day and then flipped for like Instagram, you know, Coachella Olympics bullshit, you know. So it's funny. So I went over there and Alicia and Remy were coming up at the top. Now remember, they They're posting basically in real time while they're there. So there's a lot of criminal organizations down here. And I know this because of when I used to be an EMT and stuff. And they like to go and go into places like Coachella. And because, you know, people, these criminal organizations, like the one, like the guy I breathed for who had the tat. Yeah, they'll go into these places and target people to, like, steal, mug. They don't care. I mean, these are people who are running, like, drugs from Mexico. They don't care, okay? And so they will, to pick up extra money, you know, go into, like, the festivals and stuff and mug and chisult people. Because a lot of these people are carrying around money or cash, or even like they'll steal their shit for, like, you know, like identity theft. These people don't care about, like, getting on camera for, like, stealing, like, some money out of your ATM or whatever, figuring that shit out. Like, they got bigger problems. So this is like a great crash grab. And I just, yeah, you hear the stories about people who get brought into the ER and stuff. And it's just concerning, you know, to see, like, you know, here's Alicia, like, what, she had her phone stolen a few years ago. And now it's her camera. Whatever camera that is. I mean, still, like, there's no awareness, apparently. Like, it's scary, and, like, your friends aren't paying attention. Like, apparently Remy wasn't paying attention. Something really bad's gonna happen one day to wake somebody up, and then the party's just gonna be fucking over. It's like, you know, we're just gonna flip off the camera and say everybody's a hater when that's not really what hate is. Hate is not liking someone because of something they can't change. And not because somebody's opinion about safety rules is not hate. Saying. And from someone who lives down here, who knows this valley, who knows the dark side of this because around it, I know. What do I know? I'm just a nobody on YouTube, which is fine. It's fine. I'm fine. Like I said, sometimes it's kind of nice because I can do whatever I want. When you're invisible, you can do whatever you want and nobody cares. So that's kind of the advantage to that. You can do whatever you want because nobody's looking because nobody cares. There's just a few of us here, and I think we're gonna still have fun and stuff, and could probably do a lot more because, you know, we're not, like, beholden to, like, an algorithm or money or AdSense. We're here to have fun. We've been doing fun every day since December 1st, 2023. I don't know if every day's been fun. It's normal. Like, life is normal. And that was also the other reason why I liked starting to daily vlog, was because I wanted to show, you know, like, life is, this is life. Like, some days you're just gonna hang out and have a reset day like me and get some meal prepping and work on some art and get your shit together. And that's okay. It's fine. It's normal. Not every day is like a day in the life of a Kardashian. Right? So I was watching Girl World. I was watching Frenchie earlier. Foodie Beauty update. Foodie's still in Canada, guys. She had the ER thing, right? So she's living with, I think, her aunt Phyllis. And they were making cauliflower pizzas, which, I hope she's sticking to her diet, inshallah, right? Like, and it's probably better for her to be in Canada. Like, there's a lot going on by Kuwait. So, I think the airspace was shut down. So, it's like, You need to get your health in check, Foodie. We need you around. Like I said, I think Foodie would be the same person skinny. I think it would be even more fun to see her skinny and dieting. She would rage at us all the time because she would have to be eating healthy and dieting, and she'd be getting skinny, but like she wouldn't be eating the thing. She would still rage. She would be the same person. That's what I'm saying. And she would have more energy and more time to be that person. So I'm like, lose the weight so we can, you know, see this amped up, because I think it would amp it up. I love how my battery still is at half. It's still at half. I'm like waiting for it to die or go to the red, and it's still sitting at half. It's magical. That's magical. The battery that never died. It's a YouTube miracle. My battery is still at half right now. I love that. I love that for me. Can you tell my allergies are so bad right now? It is blowing. There is a light haze, and it is dirt. Now, we live by sand dunes, so that does not help us. Oh. Patrick's calling me from the store. I gotta go. Boom. So, we got the chicken in there. Counters were sanitized. And then chicken. Yeah, I know. Sometimes we put up Frank up here for his pill because it's just easier. And so, like, that's our clean counter that we keep sanitized. Plus, we keep this sanitized over here. And, yeah. Yeah, sanitized, right? So, like, I know that's, like, a thing. You see people with, like, their cats on the counters and then they don't sanitize them.
Yeah.
Like, that happens. Their cats, they'll hop up there. But, like, that's what, like, Clorox and bleach and, you know, antiseptics and alcohol, rubbing alcohol and vodka. Have you ever cleaned with vodka?
No.
I think when we were house waters, we had this, like, bottle of vodka that maybe the lady who was in there before us left, because there was like a renter situation. Oh,
I think it's boiling. Yeah,
yeah. It's boiling.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, and I was using it to clean the glass because it was there. So I'm cooking the orzo pasta. So, I'm gonna double batch it. It said 1 cup to 2 quarts water, but I'm putting 2 cups. We'll see how much it gets. And then I have, I can't see my face. And then I have a, pasta, like a strainer to help me strain it, since it's like rice pasta, so you can probably help me pour that.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. That's what we're doing, just meal prepping. Chilling, hanging out, reset day. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Then eventually I'm gonna get to my art, so yeah. More cooking stuff, so I'm heating up some frozen green beans because, you know, they flash freeze frozen food, so it's actually not less nutritious as, like, you know, fresh. You know, that was something I learned when I was, like, in a nutrition course in college. And this lady kind of, she used to work for, like, I don't know, like, state of California for, like, CalFresh or something. I don't know, as a nutritionist or something. But she said that was just one of those things, you know. They were able to flash freeze the vegetables at that point, so it's, they're not like, it's better than nothing, you know. So, oh, had you balancing on part of the scissors over there. Seeing about it, and keeping Frank off the counter and not having to sanitize, because I don't like to eat them. I think it would be great to put him on the chair, because the gravity would help the pill go down his throat, because he was trying to flick it out and stuff. But, like, can get it down his throat that way, I think. Yeah. I don't know, put some carrots in there as well. I got my orzo.
through my orzo. So I'm gonna put it all together with some cranberries, and I'm gonna make like a Dijon honey mustard like dressing. So I'm just gonna like eyeball it, but I'm gonna take Dijon mustard. I'm gonna take these three things and I'm gonna put them together and I'm gonna stir, and then I'm gonna put it on top of my orzo vegetable mixture with the dry cranberries and hope it tastes good. Yeah, I don't know, carrots. I thought it was a great way to get some whole grains and stuff, and then to go with the chicken. I just thought would be a really tasty meal. I know chicken's got a bunch of like fucking cheese on it and stuff, but yeah. So. Continuing the meal prep, I just wanted to update you guys, let you know what it was that I was kind of putting together. Since we're meal prepping for the week and stuff, we're gonna have sushi for dinner. Yes, and he's also getting me Dutch Brothers because we were like, coffee sounds kind of nice. I know it sounds weird, but I get rolls, you know, I get the fried roll, and I get like, which is a fried California roll, and I get the like, you know, what's it called? We usually get the raw stuff on special occasions and stuff. I like the rolls normally. I know, but we're gonna be better this week. We're meal prepping. Yeah. Yeah, so for today, we're having sushi. Hello. Yes, it's dark. I hold it like this. It'll auto adjust. Oh yeah, better. Oh yeah, that's better. Ah. I'm eating my lunch. It's actually came out really freaking good, the food. Came out really good. So I just put the chicken on top. So last night, sorry, I'm not editing that out. We all cough. So I ate and I had to take my pill for my tumor, and I just was not feeling good. So I just lay down and I fell asleep. And then I woke up about 10:30 at night. And then it tossed and turned all night. I woke up this morning. I did walk on the treadmill. I forgot to like do a time lapse of that. But I walked on the treadmill for 30 minutes without the vest. And that was pretty good. My allergies are still freaking bad. But yeah, I'm doing good. Hanging out with Frank. He's over here. He took his pill on the chair, which I think is going to be easier and easier on not using so much cleaning products and shit. So yeah, go Frank taking his pill on the chair. So yeah. Yeah, so on that note, I'm also editing. I almost got the editing done. Yeah, so I'm gonna go get this done, move on to the next vlog. Yeah, the LA Times is also reporting Coachella is dead. We have to drive out to Frank's vet later to pick up his pill, so we'll get to check out dead Coachella. Because according to the LA Times, Coachella's dead. Way to go. The influencers killed it. Yeah, bad music. Killed it. So yeah, as always, link below. My nephew, my favorite nephew's YouTube channel will be linked. And yeah, I hope you guys are safe. Be safe. Follow the safety tips. If you go to a music festival, watch your friends, watch your drunk friends, watch, you know, pay attention so that nobody's shit gets stolen. Because there are people that are going to be looking for drunk people not paying attention, and they're going to target you for XYZ. So, yeah. I will see you guys in the next one. I love you. Bye. Mwah.
This is KDMYT, transmitting from a facility.